Tell our listeners a little bit about Roaring River Bread Company and where you're located and how you began.
We began, actually, I've been baking for 17 years, but we began the business 7 years ago. We are located in a production bakery north of Roaring River State Park. Production bakery meaning I don't have a storefront. We do farmers markets, we do delivery in Eureka Springs, and we're on the locally grown website. And so we have all of that going for us. And we produce breads, about 20 different varieties actually, some of them more seasonally than others.
All right, and Christie, what's your role in the company?
My role is accountant, bookkeeper, and assistant baker. And then I actually do a lot of the breakfast breads. We each have our own section that we take care of. Larry does more of the sourdoughs and ciabattas, focaccias, and then I do the whole grain breads and the breakfast breads. So we just kind of split our roles a little bit.
All right, Christie, lead us through these products, would you?
Well, let me see. We'll start on this end.
All right.
We have cinnamon raisin should be right here. It's gone already. And cranberry raisin pecan. They're both an oatmeal-based bread. These are morning glory muffins, which we say have all five food groups, so they're a good way to start off your day. Low-fat, low-sugar granola. Fabulous English muffins.
Now, English muffins are hard to make, aren't they?
English muffins are impossible to make, and we're from Kansas City, where Wolferman's English muffins were king, so we've worked on these for a long time. You have to bake them on a griddle. You have to turn them over very carefully. I turn them over with my hands and hold them suspended for a minute, and we have fabulous English muffins. So.
And they're handcrafted, it
yes,
sounds like.
Yes, they certainly are. And Fred Mayer said, if you take a canning jar ring and crack an egg in it, it exactly fits the top of this English muffin.
All right, very good.
What a McDonald's.
Oh,
that's right.
Yeah. And what is this wonderful looking product here?
This one is 100% whole wheat bread. We grind this in our bakery. We put everything in the mixer first, and then we grind it up, race to the mixer, so it is as soft and as high as regular white bread, but it's all whole wheat. It has a little honey, little olive oil, and it's just super good for you. It's
well,
purest whole wheat bread.
It looks wonderful, and it looks like you've got some small French-type loaves here.
We started off with this. This is Roaring River Harvest. It was an old recipe called strew-on that was from the Hebrides, and it's supposed to have all the grains for the harvest. So it even had brown rice when we started, but we never could remember to do it the night before, so now we don't have brown rice, but it has everything else in it.
All right.
And then I think I'm going to have Larry tell you about these because some of these are his.
Okay, very
good.
Very good.
Come talk about this because I never do it right.
Okay, talk to that lady over there. We've got a customer. Prairie Grain Dan is a bread that I created. Some of these we appropriate from other people and adapt them and so forth. But this one I created myself. It is made with rye, wheat, millet, corn, sunflower seeds, and honey. And so it has, and if I'll describe it, because I cut it in the form of a wheat stalk, and then you can actually see the millet and the very fine development of the inside of the loaf. And so it is, I mean, it really is good looking and it is outstanding tasting. It's our highest number of grains we have in anything.
Well, everything that I'm looking at is exquisite. I mean, it's beautiful to look at and I'm sure it's good to taste. Tell us about when your day begins and how all of this goes from raw materials, ingredients, into something quite wonderful.
Well, of course, we start with all organic flour, except the one that she described. We start with the organic wheat berries for the 100% whole wheat. My day starts at 5 o'clock in the morning when we're baking, and I then do a lot of the sourdoughs and the various Italian breads, and actually I also do the prairie grain because that was my own recipe. And we start in, we mix, and then it sits. Bread rests a lot. The more bread rests and ferments, the better the development and the better the flavor. That's the whole trick to artisan bread. And we have one that's an 18-hour Italian, and it takes literally 18 hours of fermentation overnight and in the waiting process before it goes in the oven.
My goodness.
So it is, yeah. And you can't, it's not your average white bread, but it is white bread, but it's fabulous tasting. And so that's it. And we start mixing, then it sits, then we mix it again a little bit, then it sits maybe anywhere from 60 to 90 minutes, and then we do what is called folding it. You pull the dough. We don't knead generally. We pull the dough and turn it and so forth to let it all the temperatures mix and to develop that gluten inside it, the protein gluten, so that it makes a very strong loaf. And then you put it back in and let it go for another 60 or 90 minutes. And then you start measuring out the various pieces. That is the important thing we do. We don't use cups. We don't use teaspoons, tablespoons. We measure everything on a scale because that's the professional baker's way of doing things, actually. Uh-huh. Yeah, you have something?
What Larry's forgotten to tell you is that this bread rests for an hour, but we start things every 15 minutes, and we have a timer on top of everything. So each of us have a timer on top of everything that goes off every 15 minutes. And so you have to run around going, whose is it, and what do we do next? So it is, they rest, and we are just working like crazy people.
But to her credit, she has put together, in broadcasting, you know, they have the log that tells you exactly when the commercials are going to run and what's going to happen next in programming. We do the same thing with the bread. It is down by minute by minute when it's going to be mixed, second mixed, what we call the folding process, and so forth. There's an absolute log that is timed. And so if we forget where we are, you just go look at the log.
What time is it?
Oh, that's right. It's time for the sourdough to be folded.
All right.
It's a zoo.
Yeah, great. Tell folks where they can find you.
We are at the Eureka Springs Farmers Market on Thursdays. We open at, we're usually there by 7:30, and we're there till noon. Christie then delivers to Eureka Springs, and if you have an interest in having bread delivered to your store in Eureka Springs, we would be happy to do that for you. We put you on our email list, and every week we say, here it is, and we send out our menu of what we're going to be baking that week. And we also are on the locally grown website, so we are taking orders up through Tuesday noon, from Sunday afternoon until Tuesday noon. And then on Thursdays, that bread and all the other wonderful produce from the locally grown comes to St. James Episcopal Church up on Prospect. And we're also then on Fridays, we're at Holiday Island and that farmer's market. That's where we're standing this morning. And we're there, we get here usually about 7:30 on Friday morning. The market opens at 8, and we're here till noon, and unless we sell out.
Well, this is the fascinating array of products and a fascinating process and business. We thank you so much, Christie and Larry Wagner, for being our guests. Friends, thanks for tuning in to the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour, brought to you by Carroll County Fresh. We are your source of organic radio. We're not always perfect. We're not always pretty, but we're always fresh, local, and honest. If you are a writer, a painter, a craftsperson, a recycler, especially if you are a farmer or involved in a small-scale food business, we would love to have you appear on the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour. Please contact us through the CarrollCountyFresh.com website or email me, DanielCroats@gmail.com. Many thanks to David Bell for being on the program with us today, along with Julia Childless and Larry and Christie Wagner of Roaring River Bread Company. I encourage you to buy their bread and eat it. We are not being paid to endorse this product. We are just customers, and we like it. Until next week, thanks for tuning in, and now go out and grow something.
One, two, one, two, three, four.